He's given up a lengthy fight to keep his name secret, but former Warriors and Kiwis league player Manu Vatuvei is vowing to keep battling serious meth charges, some of which carry a maximum life sentence. For almost a year and a half, we couldn't tell you his name, but last night he outed himself. Kim Baker Wilson's been following his case.
He's been fighting for more than a year to hide his name, but not any longer.
Just wanted to get something off my chest, but in 2019 I was charged with importation, possession and supply of methamphetamine.
This is 2019. The former sports star, his lawyer and one of his first hearings. One of many appearances that couldn't be shown at the time because of his name suppression.
And the law does actually say that just because you're well known, that in itself does not create extreme hardship. You've got to have something more.
After his arrest in a joint police and customs investigation, Manu Vatuvei argued his fair trial rights would be breached if his name was made public and future jobs would suffer. But a district court judge shot those down, saying there was simply no evidence his trial rights would be breached and there was no logical connection.
He then came here to the High Court to appeal against that decision. Again, he raised fair trial rights and his lawyer said that open justice needed to wait. And again, the judge dismissed the application.
He had until this week to take that to a higher court, but instead, he's revealed himself.
Well, I think people are maybe wise to get ahead of the game if for example, like in this case where the appeal hasn't been taken any further.
Since his league farewell, there's been dancing with the stars and a new career in real estate.
And this is a second bedroom.
Now there's this, what he calls a battle.
All these charges are accusations and I'll be fighting.
Manu Vatuvei applied for a real estate licence after his charges were laid. The real estate authorities told One News it too has just learned of the charges. He heads to trial later this year. Kim Baker Wilson, One News.